Frank Kremble, ETN2, Electronics Technicians Communications, second class. I started back in boot camp, Great Lakes, 1966. Went through Great Lakes. Came out as an electronics designate. Went up down to La Jolla, down to San Diego. We were there for like 6 weeks for first school I went to. Then we headed up to San Francisco, Treasure Island, up in the middle of the bay there, and there for a year for basic electronics. Then I went out to the first ship, which was the America. Met her in the Philippines, flew out to the Philippines, met her out there. But it was really impressive. You know, you get on board and then just trying to find where you slept, where you ate, you know, and trying to find your way around the darn thing. That was the main thing. There was so many compartments, so many different areas. And then we went 1968. We were up in the Gulf of Tonkin, on a Yankee station. Luckily the ship was all air conditioned. And I worked in electronics, so all the compartments that the equipment was in was air conditioned, so I did not have it tough. Well, I took care of all the UHF radios, which they used to communicate between the airplane and the ship. Took care of the HF radio, which was tied into the Navy Tactical Data Systems, which was the umbrella. They sent up an E-2 Hawkeye, and they would transmit information from CIC and get radar information back from the Hawkeye, and then they would each transmit out to all the ships in the squadron. So everybody saw each other, and they saw all the planes, and they knew who was friendly or not. They had all the same picture. So that was a neat thing on that. Worked through the data systems people, and you know, so that's primarily what I did. It was a 9-month cruise total, so we were on station for 6 months. One of the most memorable things is they had they were given an air show for the South Koreans, and they forgot to tell us that they were practicing. We were in the chow hall, and there was two F-4s, one over the front of the ship, one over the back of the ship, and broke the sound barrier at the same time. And they didn't tell us that they were practicing. So we thought, you know, I thought a bomb had gone off, but luckily they were just practicing. That was pretty impressive, you know. And then to watch, finally get up and watch them do it sitting on the flight deck was pretty impressive to watch that. They had a live fire exercise. We were dragging a skid, and they had a Gatling gun on an A-7 Corsair, and they strafed the sled. And they had an A-6 intruder with a bomb load and dropping bombs. It was pretty impressive. Better than any air show I've seen. A civilian. We went around the world on the 68 cruise. There was Hong Kong. Well, the favorite was Australia. In Australia, they treated us like gold. The people were really great to us during Vietnam. Anytime you cross the equator, before you cross the equator, you're a polywog, so they say. And then once you cross the equator, then you get introduced to the Order of the Shellback. And they do some crazy things. They have you laying in garbage. They have you put grease in your hair. And nobody's immune. I mean, they had officers there. Even the captain. If the captain's not a shellback, he's got to go through the same thing. You know, it's just a Navy thing. It's a crazy thing, but that's the way it is. And turn around, came back. 69, we were in the yards, Philadelphia, or not the Norfolk yard. They were working on a ship there for a year. Then we headed out back in 70 again, back to Westpac. Same thing, Yankee Station, 9 month cruise, 6 months online. I asked for a transfer to new construction.